30 days of CrossFit as a beginner. Why? What do you think, Ellie? Do you have anything to say? What about you? So I'm currently stuck in Idaho because Texas fell through and all I do is work and sit at my computer all day, so I need something to do, okay? I'm going to be filming every 5 days, so buckle up because I honestly have no idea what I'm doing. I spent 30 days at CrossFit as a gym noob. Okay, so for those of you who don't know what CrossFit is, CrossFit, according to Google, is a form of high-intensity interval training. CrossFit is a strength and conditioning workout that is made up of functional movement performed at a high-intensity level. These movements and actions that you perform in your day-to-day life, like squatting, pulling, pushing, etc. The first day of CrossFit consisted of a lot of deadlifts and bicep curls and tricep extensions, so it was pretty low-key and easy for the most part.
You want to come say hi? Yeah. This is the mic.
Hi. Hello, everybody. Welcome to CrossFit.
Introduce yourself. Who are you?
I'm Cody. I'm Chloe's brother-in-law, so we're getting Chloe started here at CrossFit, so.
These are called monster walks, apparently. My brain can't process how to do this backwards. This is really awkward because like my dentist is here right now and he's also conveniently like super hot, so. Yeah, I love working out in front of my hot dentist. I still don't understand how to do this backwards. I don't think I'm doing it correctly. 15 banded glute bridges. It's a warm up and I'm already sweating. I've never done a deadlift.
I'm Esteban, Chloe's friend. We're here working out today, doing CrossFit. Chloe's second day. We'll see how it goes, doing some deadlifts.
So we do two sets of five, two sets of three, and then one big one at the end. I'm strong as fuck. You know what made this possible though? Ghost energy. Okay, we're doing bicep curls and tricep extensions. I don't know how I'm gonna play Overwatch later, bro. Hey, so as you saw from one of my most recent videos that I posted on Twitter, I am now partnered with Ghost Energy. Shout out to them for sending me all of this amazing product. Seriously, I cannot thank them enough. They literally sent me so much stuff. And I have tried everything that they've sent me. So they sent me the protein powder. They sent me the Chips Ahoy one. They sent me a ton of these gamer energy ones. And then they also sent me two of their hydration formula, which I literally drink daily. Like, I cannot express to you how much I use their products in my daily life. Even before I was partnered with them, I love their cans. They're just amazing. They have so many benefits and they are zero sugar. So shout out to Ghost for sending me all this product and partnering with me. If you would like to get 15% off your purchase, please use code BAGEL. It would really mean a lot to me and it supports me directly. So thank you.
Hello and welcome to day 5 of CrossFit. Today I kind of wanted to go over some things that I've been working on. So I've really been trying to eat better. I kind of just want to integrate like little things just to kind of get rid of my bad habits slowly and smoothly instead of making like a huge big change at once, because I don't think I can do that. So my biggest downfall is snacking. I love to snack. It's like my favorite thing ever. So I got some snacks at the store. Don't ask me about nutrition specifics because I don't really know them. My goal is whenever I'm feeling hungry, I'm gonna take from any of these Ghost Energy. Shout out to you, getting me off that sugar, get me on this good stuff. And then during my workout, I usually drink some Ghost Hydration. I've been really digging the strawberry kiwi. I also have the lemon crush flavor. I usually throw like a scoop and a half of this into the really tall Ghost shakers and it is awesome. It gets me through my workout and then I can also drink it after.
as well to stay hydrated. I also kind of wanted to show you what I wear to CrossFit. It depends on the day. They post the workouts online of what is going on for the day. So you can kind of just like base your outfit on that. But this is kind of one of my favorite combos. These are Kill Crew shorts. I really like them because they have pockets and they are adjustable. They're really stretchy. They're just really comfortable. I love these. I have like 3 or 4 pairs of them and they're literally the best. And then this top, this is actually from REI. Literally so comfy. It's really stretchy and I don't have to wear like a sports bra with it. And I don't generally have to like adjust it while I'm working out. And that's like a big thing for me. I hate adjusting my clothing when I'm working out because it distracts me. I don't like it. And then I always wear a flat bottom type of shoe. Because you do a lot of lifting in CrossFit and you always want a flat bottom shoe when you're lifting. So I usually opt for my Blazers or I use my Noble shoes. Day 5 was one of the more hard days. Unfortunately, the music was too loud, so I didn't get a lot of good footage. But here's a rundown of what we did.
I'm in the corner by myself. So funny. You missed it, but we did 8 scab pull-ups. I just didn't want to move the camera, so. We're doing 8 reps for 8 minutes. For those of you who don't know, AMRAP means as many rounds as possible. Everything after this is just like accessory work. Those pull-ups killed me. This is the last one, it's just a band and glute bridge. Holy shit, today was a lot. I think that's it for today. Hopefully you guys can hear me. I don't know, the music was so loud during the regular warm-up that I don't think you could hear me, but holy crap. It's like only day 5, and it literally feels like I've been doing this for 30 days already. This is gonna be a long 30 days, but.
Day 10 of CrossFit was one of the hardest days by far. I have never done so many burpees in my life, and I've never rowed so much in my life. We rowed around 3,500 meters total, which is insane, and we had to get it all done in under 32 minutes. So let's take a look at what we did.
Welcome to day 10 of CrossFit. I'm almost done with this challenge. We got 5 more days. All right, we're starting off with a 2,000 meter row. Ooh. Okay, so now we're doing 50 burpees with no push up to box jump. Or step up. I would never wish those burpees box steps on my worst enemy. Holy shit. We're doing a 1K, bro. Code bagel. Okay, so 50. We're gonna step over and go under. Oh, those don't look that hard, but they're pretty rough. We do 500 meter row. One more exercise after this. Okay. I suck. I get swinging too much. Yeah. We're done. Yeah, we did it. All right. Oh my God. So that concludes day 10 of CrossFit. Today was probably the roughest day by far.
Not even gonna lie. That hurt. But we did it. So I will see you on day 15, my last part of my 30-day CrossFit challenge.
And now that brings me to my final day of CrossFit, day 15, which was done over 30 days. I wanted to interview every single person that coached me and kind of helped me through this process. So here's those. All right, what's your name and how long have you been doing CrossFit for?
Katie Rigby, and I've been doing it for 8 years now.
Carolyn Beninsight, and I have been doing CrossFit for 6.5 years.
Participating for 8 years, coaching, I think 5 or 6 years. That's amazing. It does not seem like that long at all.
That is participating. I've been a coach for almost 2 years.
What's your favorite part about CrossFit? The community. I like all the people pretty much, and the fact that anybody can do it. It's just a good group fitness environment.
My favorite part is actually the community. I like building relationships with the other members, and as a coach, you know, building those relationships with the athletes and then also seeing them grow, you know, and become stronger and more confident.
Yeah. I would recommend CrossFit to others just because, like I said, the community is awesome. The social aspect of it is great, mainly because going to like a regular gym, I just got really bored with it. And
Absolutely. So
yeah. I wanted something to challenge me. And so coming here, if I get bored, I can't just walk out. Like I got all my people around me telling me like, come on, Katie, let's keep going. So that's a huge part for me.
I would recommend it because of the community. You build relationships. It does build your confidence. Everybody encourages you and builds you up. And it doesn't matter what your athletic ability is coming into the gym. Everything is modifiable. So if you have an injury even, you know, we can modify things. So we can strengthen those muscles so you can actually do a, you know, box jump or whatever the case may be. But
today we have a 40-minute AMRAP or 10 rounds, which is a 1,000-meter bike or 1,400-meter row, 5 burpee ring muscle-ups, 3 hang squat cleans, and 1 box jump. And then each new round, you add 10 pounds to your squat clean. Goal is strong but sustained effort across all rounds. So I guess let's see how that goes. So we're adding weight every time we do the round. So we're adding 5 each side. And then next round, I'll take off these 5s and I'll just pull on the 10s. I'm fucking dying. Holy shit. Should I increase weight? Probably. We'll see if I can do it. All right. That's heavy. That was a good one.
butterball.
We did it.
So thank you for coming along this journey with me. I enjoyed CrossFit a lot, and it's definitely something I want to continue to do in the future. So yes, I'm going to renew my membership, and I'm going to continue doing CrossFit probably around 2 to 3 times a week. So yeah, thank you. And if you want to see more content like this in the future, please subscribe, leave a comment down below, leave a like, and thank you so much again.